morning to all present here. I'm happy to see many friends here, and I'm very happy to be with all of you. This event, which has been organized, is focused on the MSMEs, micro, small, and medium enterprises. That is what we call in India MSMEs. Honorable Minister for MSME, Shri Kalraj Mishra, could not come due to exigencies of work, but he has sent his good wishes for this event, and he has also sent a high-level delegation of National Small Industrials Corporation, led by Mr. Rabindranath, who is present with us today. India-Singapore partnership has grown significantly to the mutual advantage of both countries since the establishment of diplomatic relations 50 years ago. Amongst the ASEAN countries, Singapore is the second largest trading partner of India and the largest investment partners, both ways, for India. That means the investments from Singapore to India and the investments from India to Singapore have a very healthy level of over $30 billion each side. Singapore is an important destination for Indian businesses, trade, as well as Indian students and tourists. The 50-year milestone is an opportunity to celebrate and to build on the already strong base to our relationship to yet a further level. In fact, time is now ripe for a quantum jump in our economic relationship. India, one of the largest economies of the world, is now one of the fastest growing emerging markets with an average annual growth rate of close to 8%. There are positive signals that suggest that the Indian economy may be moving to an even higher level of growth trajectory. IMF, World Bank, credit agencies, experts speak with optimism about India due to the many positive policies of the government of India. One of the major initiatives of Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi is the Make in India initiative, and that is to encourage local and foreign companies to manufacture the products in India. There is an initial focus on 25 sectors, which include automobiles, chemicals, IT, pharmaceuticals, textiles, ports, aviation, tourism, among others. And I see that from the delegation that has come from India, representatives of this sector, these industries are here, and I'm sure you will get an opportunity to talk to them and to exchange opportunities about business that exists. In fact, in all the 25 sectors, there is 100% FDI allowed, except in space, which has a 74% limit, defense, which has a 49% limit, and news media, which has 26% limit, but I would encourage you, you must need to go with 26% to India to invest there. There is Radio Masti. I'm sure you're going to go there to India. This initiative of the Government of India has been supplemented and supported by many processes for the ease of doing business in India with simpler licensing and deregulation measures and by significantly increasing the speed and transparency involved. A dedicated portal has been created by the Government of India to facilitate foreign investors as well as to answer queries from them in one portal. Most importantly, the Make in India initiative represents an attitudinal change, a shift in how India relates to investors, not as a permit issuing authority, but as a true business partner who wants to welcome you to India. Since the launch of the Make in India initiative, there have been many success stories, and just to mention some of them, Samsung, that is going to manufacture Samsung ZI in its plant in Noida. Hitachi, which will set up an auto component plant in Chennai in 2016. Huawei, which has opened a new R&D campus in Bengaluru. Airbus, which will manufacture its products in India and invest $2 billion. So you see that there is a shift towards India in manufacturing, and today I was reading that Foxconn is going to move to India to manufacture its Apple products there as well. So would Singapore like to join this is a question I have for you, and I'm confident the answer will be yes. In fact, if you just go back a few months, when Prime Minister was in Germany, and he was there at the largest industrial fair, Hannover Messe, there was an unprecedented level of interest from investors in building partnerships in trade, in investment, and in innovation in India. Thus, you can see that the Make in India initiative has gained tremendous momentum. Can India and Singapore SMEs work together, and can we manufacture together? I have already said that I have confidence that it can happen. Let me go through the SME sector as it exists in India, briefly as it exists in India and as it exists in Singapore. The SME sector in India generates about 100 million jobs in over 46 million units situated throughout the geographical expanse of the country. The sector has sustained an annual growth rate of 10% for the past few years. With 38% contribution to the nation's GDP and 40% share of overall exports, clearly the sector has a significant role to play to meet the national imperatives of manufacturing and of generating employment. Further, SMEs nurture and support the development of new age entrepreneurs, and they have been success stories. We have with us Mr. Mahesh Gupta, he was speaking to me and he mentioned to me he started as a very, very small unit, and today it's a household name in India. So here is a new, is an entrepreneur who has worked through this. And we do hope that through the SME route, you will have many new generation entrepreneurs. The young will come with wonderful ideas. India is a land where it's a land of ideas, it's a land of creativity, it's a land of innovation. So you would see a lot happening in India in innovations also. Silicon Valley moving to India? Assessments are yes. So should you move to India? My answer is yes. So this new wave of MSMEs would therefore be creating an ecosystem that would be geared to delivering the right product, the right quality, the right solution and the right service at competitive prices, both in domestic as well as in international markets. The Government of India is fully supportive of MSMEs. I would only mention the Mudra Bank that has been set up with a corpus of about $3.3 billion and a credit guarantee corpus of $500 million. Similarly, there is the National Skills Mission to develop the employability of the youth. So you're looking at credit, you're looking at skill building, and you have already 46 million units. You are ready to go. I'm sure that the CMD of the National Small Industries Corporation, NSIC, Mr. Rabindranath, would give you the details about India's SME policies. NSIC is working with the Ministry of MSME, and it promotes, aids, and fosters the growth of SMEs with a set of specially tailored schemes to enhance competitiveness by providing integrated support services through marketing, technology, and financial support, and he will be giving you the details of how that works. Singapore SMEs, on the other side, are also becoming more active overseas, with the stock of direct investment abroad increasing from Singapore dollars, 29 billion, in 2004 to 52 million in 2013, almost doubling up in about less than 10 years. And as Singapore companies internationalize to build scale and access new markets and customers, India can be the new location for manufacturing for Singapore companies. I would say that Singapore companies will find Indian SMEs eager and good partners. So I hope we will be going there soon. We do know that a delegation of SME companies from Singapore is to go to India. CII has been working on it, But now I'm sure CII and MSIC together work on this initiative. And since I'm present here, let me tell you, India and Singapore work together in many areas and we work together very well. We had last year at the United Nations, I worked in the UN, I know the system, how it works, when India moved a resolution to declare 21st June at the initiative of Prime Minister Narendra Modi as the International Day of Yoga. It was supported by an overwhelming number of countries, including Singapore. So we are happy that Singapore joined us in supporting our resolution. And we in Singapore are now organizing the International Day of Yoga on 21st June. There would be over 50 centers in Singapore itself. And I would urge all of you to come join in that very momentous and historic event and to do yoga with, together, all of us, on 21st June. And any one of you interested in registration should go to the website www.idaeofyoga.org/Singapore. And I hope to see many of you there. Here, I will just end by wishing the conference the very best. And I also wish Prosperous Events, who has put a tremendous amount of effort, a great success in the journey that they have embarked on. And I thank all of you for being present here and wish you great success, which we will measure in terms of how many business tie-ups are done, and we will measure it in terms of how much investment moves to India and how many SMEs of the two sides work together. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.